Good morning, children, and I hope you all are the best of health here. And I'm very happy to come once again to the second section. First, I completed explaining on the sentence, and I hope you all have understood because I explained in a very simple English there. Okay, so today let me start the next chapter, which is nouns, very important chapter in English. Okay, so I hope you all will understand and see. Now first let me tell you what is a noun. A noun is a name of a person, place, animal or thing. A noun is a name of person, place, animal or thing. Or you can just think that noun is a naming word. A noun is a naming word which we give to the things or the persons or the places. Now, in noun there are different kinds of nouns. Today let me explain you about any five of them. So first, let me explain the nouns, how many nouns there are. So first is common noun, then proper noun, then abstract noun, material noun and collective noun. There are five types of nouns which I am going to explain you. First, let me tell you what is a common noun. What is a common noun? A common noun is a noun which is given in general, a name which is given in general to everything. For example, here girls. Now, if I say girls, so all girls will stand. If I say boys, the boys will stand. Because that is a name which is given in general to every person. Okay. One more is city. See, there are many cities. Many cities in our country. So city means it comes in general. But when I say the name of the city, that comes properly. So common noun is the name which is given in general to any person, place, animal or thing. Okay, like dogs. So number of dogs. So, dogs means it's a kind of animal. Lion, it's a kind of animal. Now if I say book, it's a kind of material. Okay, but if I say English reader, so English reader is the name given to that book. So it becomes proper noun. But common noun is the noun which is given in general. So this is called common noun. The common noun always starts with small letters, not capital letters. So small letter will be written in common noun. Now coming from common noun to proper noun. Now what is proper noun? Proper noun is a name, a special name given to some person, place, animal or thing. A special name is given to some person, place, animal or thing. For example, I have written here Ramu. Ramu is the name given to one boy. See, boy is common noun and his name Ramu is a proper noun. Okay. Because that's a special name given by his parents. Next is Mumbai. Mumbai is a name which is given to a place. It's a city in Maharashtra which is given a special name Mumbai. So that is called proper noun. Proper nouns are special names given to the nouns like person, place, animal or thing. So they are called proper noun. Keep in mind, proper nouns are always starting letter will be capital. So, see, R is capital, M is capital. Okay, so in proper noun, the first letter of the word will be capital. So that is proper noun. Now coming to abstract noun. Now what is abstract noun? Abstract nouns are the nouns which shows our feelings. Which shows our feeling. We cannot see or we cannot touch, but we can only feel. That is our feeling. So, for example, your happiness and old age. See, we cannot see our happiness, only we can feel it. We can feel our sadness. We can feel our happiness, but we cannot see or we cannot touch. Nobody can touch happiness. Nobody can touch sadness, but we can feel it. Now, we cannot see our old age. If I want to see my old age, I cannot see. I become old by the time pass, but I cannot see in before. Same way, I cannot see my childhood. If I want to see my childhood back, I can't see it. That is only our feelings. It is only our feelings. So the words which tells us about our feelings, they are called abstract nouns. Now coming to next is material noun. Material noun is the name given to the materials like gold, silver, wood, okay, books. So whatever materials, liquids, petrol, diesel, water, these are all the material only. So the material noun is like gold and wood, for example. They are called material noun. The name which is given to a certain materials. Okay. Now coming to the collective noun. Collective noun. Collective noun is one word or one name is given to a big thing, like many things together. Like suppose a group of people, we say group of people, that means many people are standing and we given the word group. So a group of people, like a singular noun, single word we are given to a group. The same way army. See, soldiers, there are many thousands of soldiers are there. Many soldiers are there, but one word is given for them, that is army. Army of soldiers. So army of soldiers means what? Many soldiers together. They are called army. So army is the word which is given, a single word which is given to many things. Same way, a herd of sheep. Herd. Many ships are going together. Okay? Or many cows or buffaloes, they all are going together. So one word we have given, a herd of sheep or a herd of cows, a herd of buffaloes. So when one word is given to a number of things, they are called collective noun. So I hope you all understood what are nouns, children. Nouns is noun, there are common noun, proper noun, abstract noun, material noun, and collective noun. This all I have understood. Okay. Now coming to common and proper. Now what is common and what is proper? Just now I told you, common noun is the name which is given in general, like girl. Girl is a general name. The name of the girl is Radha. So Radha, R is capital. C, city. City is common because there are many cities. And the name of the city, I have written here Hyderabad. So Hyderabad, H is proper. Okay, capital letter. The name of the city will be proper. Now dog is common. Okay, the name of the dog is Sam. So the name of the dog is proper. Next comes country. There are many countries in the world. Okay, and the name of the country, India. So I is capital. So all the proper nouns we have to write in capitals. That is common noun and proper noun. So I hope you all have understood. For example, now the man working on the ship. The man working on the ship. What they are called? Crew. the man working on the ship. I'll just write down. So, suppose a group of monkeys, many monkeys together, they are called collective monkeys. Many monkeys together, we say crew. A group of stars, they are called constellation, constellation of stars. Okay, like that. So, many lions together. So, these lions, many lions together, we say the pride of lions. Okay, so these are the one word which is given to many things and they are called collective nouns.
What's the time? 325.
How many minutes is it?
11.
20.
Here are some more collective nouns I have written. See here collective nouns. Like a group of wolves, you know, wolves, they live in the forest, you know, wolves. A group of wolves, they are called pack. That way, you can say a pack of wolves. A group of lions, pride. This is the one word given to many lions. A group of lions, pride. A set of poems, anthology. A set of poems are called anthology. A group of soldiers, army. A group of stars, constellation. We say a constellation of stars. That means a group. There are thousands of stars in the sky. And all that stars, one name is given, constellation. When we say constellation of stars, we should understand that there are many, many, many thousands of stars in the sky. Okay. A group of players. Team. You say the cricket team or football team. So we say the team is going to abroad to play cricket. That means in one team there will be 11 to 12 players. So we will not say 11 players are going to play cricket. We say a team of players are going. So team. Team means what? The name which is given to a group of players. Okay. This is what? Collective noun. Okay. Now coming to abstract nouns, which I told that is only we can feel but we cannot see or touch. Discovery. Okay, honesty. The man is honest. Okay, we cannot see the honesty but we can see the work what he is doing. Yes, he is a very good man but his honesty is only our feeling that he is a very honest man. Invention. Invention, we cannot see only, we can feel. Poverty. Poor people. Poor people we can see, but we cannot see the poverty there. So, poverty is a abstract noun. Laughter. And information. Information also, we cannot see, only we can feel. Next comes, there are countable and uncountable nouns also. What are countable nouns? The things which we can count, like any material, books we can count, tables we can count, chairs we can count, any material like fan we can count. So whatever things we can count in numbers, they come under countable noun. And the things which we cannot count, for example sand, example salt, sugar, our hair. We can't count our hair. We can't count sand, sugar, salt. Okay. So, these type of things which we cannot count, they comes under uncountable nouns. So, uncountable and countable. Countable nouns are which we can count and uncountable nouns are which we cannot count. So, children, this section we will close here only. I have explained you about the nouns and the different kinds of nouns. I hope you all have understood and please try to make examples and study and do practice well. Next time I'll come with the next topic. Till then, goodbye and see you. All the best, children.